Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. In this video, we are going to learn about introduction to Python and basics of Python, like features of Python, applications, and where Python is used in real world and how to execute Python. Yes, let's get into the video. What is Python? So, Python is an object-oriented and highly programming language. It was created by Geodor van Rossum in early of 1990. It was designed to be highly readable language. Here, the English words are frequently used, whereas the other language use punctuations. Python contains less syntactical construction than other language. Python is also called as the interpreted language. There are some advantages of learning Python. It is interpreted so that it is processed at the runtime by the interpreter. You don't need to compile your program before executing it. It is interactive, so you can sit at a Python prompt and interact with the interpreter directly to write your own program. Python supports object-oriented style language. So, it is a great language for a beginner level programmers and support the development of wide range of applications. Features of Python. So, Python has some unique features. Easy to understand. It has only few keywords, so this allows the students to easy pick up with the language quickly. It is portable, so it can run on a wide variety of hardware platform and also has the same interface on all platforms. Extendable. Here you can add low level modules to the Python interpreter. This module enables the programmer to add or customize the tool to be more efficient. Databases. So, Python provides interfaces to all major commercial databases. It is a scalable. It provides a better structure and support for large program than shell scripting. Broad standard library. It has bulk of library, a very portable and cross-platform compatible on Unix and Windows. Python applications and where Python is used in real field. Web development. So, we can use Python for web development to create web-based applications. So, generally we use a combination of Python and JavaScript to accomplish this. Desktop application. Python is a flexible language. That is why software developers across the world use Python for developing the desktop applications. Software development. Python is a very popular open source software development language that offers to improve the process control capabilities. Education. Education industries use Python for coding. The syntax rules of Python allows you to specific concept without additional codes. Database access. So, it is a platform independent, faster and more efficient, and it supports for all relation system, also easy to migrate. Networking programming. Python allows you to build script to automate complex network configuration. So, it is the most wide used programming language for software defined networks. Game development. So, game development in Python is chosen by programming because it is an easy language to start with and is enjoyable and straightforward to master, and also used in 3D graphics. Who uses Python in real life? Google uses for better search results and providing the result it based on the ranking of the website and more. Netflix uses Python for security automation, risk classification and auto remediation. Dropbox. Here the server and client application are coded with Python. Reddit. Here the original written Common Lisp is rewritten with Python in 2005 to gain greater development flexibility and access to the Python. Instagram. The app utilizes many language, but it is application server or builds using iteration of Python. Shopify. The Shopify APL library allows Python developers to programmatically access the admin section of sectors. So how Python is executed? Yes, this is a traditional runtime execution. The source code you typed is saved as .py extension. For saving the Python file, the extension .py is used here. The compiler read into binary file. The extension used for compiler is .pyc. Then it is translated to bytecode, which is then run by the Python virtual machine. Your code is automatically compiled. Finally, the output is printed on the screen. So, I hope everyone have got a clear view on the topic Introduction to Python. Thank you for watching this video. We'll meet you soon in the next video. To get notified with our upcoming videos, do subscribe to our channel.